Welcome to the Art of Living Big podcast. My name's Betsy Paik. I'm an author, a speaker, and a trainer of NLP and hypnotherapy. And I'm focused on helping you understand and design your life with the power of the subconscious. This podcast is designed to help you think differently about what could be possible for your life. Now, let's go live big. Hello, fellow adventurers. Hi, everyone. Welcome to the show today. We are right before Christmas. Are you guys ready? Are you ready? It's weird to me. I'm ready. Like, I have the gifts either ordered or already here and wrapped. We have our tree up. I've been playing Christmas music, but something about it isn't Christmassy to me. I don't know why this year feels weird. I feel like last year I felt more in the holiday. Like last year I remember being like really into it with the holiday music and all of that. I don't know. I'm curious, is it just me? Are you guys feeling like that? I need to know. I need to know if it's just me. Okay, so I have a couple things I wanted to tell you about, and then I have a thought. So like the thought that I want to share. So okay, first thing I want to tell you about is have you guys watched the show on Netflix called 1899? Have you seen that? So we started watching it. I let me pause. If you've been here for a long time, you've heard me say I'm not a big TV watcher, and I'm really not, and I'm super careful about what I watch. And when COVID happened, I found the love of binging on Netflix shows. So Craig and I usually will like pick a show and then we will like watch one every night. And it's kind of like a, you know, we both work on, I think I work on my calendar for the next day, my list of things to do. And he plays a game on his iPad while we watch. It's like this little thing we do. It's lovely. So we started watching this 1899. And if you haven't seen it, you need to see it. By the time you get to the end, like the last two, maybe three episodes, I was like, oh my God, this is, they were speaking my language. That's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to say. But if you like this show, I think you'll like that show. If you like this podcast, I think you'll like that show. So it's called 1899. It's on Netflix. All right. I got a lot of messages about the weight show that we did. I did put some of the hypnosis inside the collective. We're doing some things inside the collective. I'm going to be working on some stuff for energy and also a money workshop. So I haven't put all of the hypnosis in there that I did to do the weight loss stuff. But I will recreate those in a way that's more professional than the versions that I had made for myself. So you heard me talk about how I did basically a cocoon day for myself. A cocoon day, if you're new here, is where someone works with me for like 6 to 8 hours and we totally reprogram one area of your life inside your unconscious mind. And then I really like using hypnosis and like the audios of hypnosis as sort of like I don't like using affirmations are great, right? Hypnosis is great. And it's really great if you've already done the change work and use it like as a supportive mechanism, right? So almost like the cocoon day, doing that work with me is when you get the braces on. You get the braces on, your teeth totally transform and you get the braces off. And then the hypnosis is like a retainer. Do you know what I mean? So it keeps everything going. So I'm going to be sharing more of that stuff. So if you've wanted to do anything with me, you know, the collective is the place to go. It's insanely inexpensive. It's a no-brainer. And it's the place where everybody will be offered anything else that I do. And I'm looking at doing some stuff, little retreats and things like that for next year, like small, intimate kind of gatherings. And that will be people in the collective will be invited first. Okay. All right. All that. I didn't mean to get into all that. Really, what I wanted to tell you was just that I was uploading some of those things. Okay. Okay. This is the next thing I wanted to tell you. I'm not really on TikTok. Remember I said I'm going to go on TikTok, and I'm realizing that it's a different thing. Like, you know how there's reels on Instagram? And the reels on Instagram are different from the TikToks. Like, the vibe is different. I don't know. I haven't totally figured it out. So I decided to just pause while I figured it out, like how I want to, what I want to do. So if you've gone over to TikTok to follow me, thank you. You're the best because it was scary over there. People are mean over there. And so I appreciate you so much. And I'm trying to figure out like the social media thing. The podcast feels natural to me because it feels like you and I are just on a phone call. But the other stuff, I don't know. I'm working on it. I'm expanding. Okay, so I just wanted to give you the TikTok update. And then I wanted to just talk about this thing that I've been thinking about. So, all right, so here's kind of how this started. And speaking of TikTok, I guess there are several TikTok accounts which are accounts that are dedicated to rehabbing old houses. So, I'm not like a house flipper. That hasn't really ever been like a thing I've been interested in. But I really like seeing like the old houses, like the old banisters and how they have all those old built-ins and the old hardwood floors and all that molding. Like, it's so pretty and beautiful. And so many times now, and I have owned them, so I am not knocking it, but there's neighborhoods where it's just like houses that are just like duplicated. Do you know what I mean? And those seem so intricate and individual. And so I've been watching a couple accounts as they have been updating, and sometimes they can save stuff like an old bathtub, and sometimes it just doesn't work. And one of the things that I keep hearing them say, and I've heard this over and over and over again, is when the if the foundation is really good, like the foundation of the house is good, then we can clean it up. We can cosmetically make it look the way we want it to look. But the foundation's got to be right. So if it's a really old house that doesn't have good wiring, they have to go back in and redo the wiring, right? Because the foundation, and not just like the foundation, like the cement of the base of the house, but like the foundational elements, you know? And when I think of like a house foundational elements, it's like the electricity, like the plumbing, has it been updated? Like, what's the heating and AC systems like in it? Like, what is the foundation? Is the foundation the actual physical foundation of the building? Is it have integrity? And when we think about integrity, we think about like, is it not broken, right? Is it whole? And I've been watching these accounts and I keep thinking about it, and I make meaning out of anything. But I was like, I think this is such an interesting metaphor for like the new year and any time of the year, any time that we're looking at reevaluating our life or making big changes in our life, right? Substantial changes that change the cosmetics. We've got to make sure that the foundation is right. And sometimes we think of foundation as like, well, that's just the thing that I have. But we can update the foundation. Like, maybe the ways in which you were brought up weren't the best. Maybe the things that you've experienced have been really hard, and those things you could think of as like the foundational years of your life were not simple or easy. But we get to choose. We get to choose. We get to say, these are all the materials that I was given. And what do I want to, what kind of house do I want to make with this? And if there's something that needs to be updated, the wires worked at one point. That plumbing worked at one point, and now it doesn't. So now I get to choose. And I get to say, this was all the stuff I was given, and this doesn't work anymore. So I'm going to upgrade. I'm gonna keep my foundation really strong so that as I want to build on it and I want to make big changes in my life and I want to create something new and I want to have these experiences, that I can do that because I've worked on the foundation. And so much of the work that I do, I consider it like foundational work, right? Like releasing negative emotions, anger, fear, hurt, guilt, sadness, like all of those things, like creating the foundation so that it is in integrity. See, I don't think we're broken at all. I see us as wholeness. And there's been so much crap that we've all been through that it starts to impact the integrity of the foundation that then we're trying to build on. And I think one of the problems with like moving into like, I'm going to use a new year just because we're here, but anytime you're listening to this, like anytime you want to start a new goal, or it's Monday, or it's the new month, or whatever it is that you have on your heart, then before you add on the second floor or the wallpaper, right, or the extra crown molding or whatever you want to do, you have to make sure the integrity of the thing can withstand whatever happens in the house. And so, you know, some of the questions as I was like watching those and started thinking about this is like, what is my foundation made up of? Like, what are my values and beliefs that create the foundation? Like, what do I really stand for? Like, what is okay in my world and what is not okay? How do I want to treat people? And how do I require people to treat me? These are just some of the things that I've been thinking of in terms of like creating and testing that integrity of my foundation. You know, this foundation that I'm talking about is really the thing that's going to hold you steady when, you know, a tornado comes through or a big storm or a hurricane. And so really taking a look. And so as we think about like, I've got these big goals, and I know for me, I think most of us with goals, it's not really things that we want to accomplish. It's things we want to experience, right? Like the goal that you have, like I remember years ago, I ran a marathon, like 26.2 miles, right? Like an actual marathon, which, you know, note to self, it's a long way. Don't do it again. But I remember when I think back to that time that I was doing it, it's not the actual event that I remember as much. It's not crossing the finish line. In fact, the memories I have of crossing the finish line are actually photos of me crossing the finish line. I don't totally remember what it was like to cross the finish line, as odd as that might sound. I mean, it was a while ago, but the things that I remember, the things that still inspire me and make me go, oh, that was so good, are the training days. Like I remember training for it, like building the foundation that allowed me to have the experience. So I think that it's the whole experience that we're really after, not really the goal of crossing the finish line, but we want to transform. Because like the person who crossed the finish line at that event wasn't the same person that took my first step when I first started running. And I was not a runner when I started. And I was like, oh, in 6 months, I think I'll run a marathon. And like, you know, and that became the all-encompassing thing that I thought of. And so I think like when we think about like what are the things you want to experience in your life, right? Maybe in this year, maybe next year, maybe 5 years from now, what are the things you want to experience in your life? And how can you create a foundation that supports that experience? What is it that will keep you steady? What do you have to rely on? And what is it that you have to know to be true? And so I wanted to leave you with that metaphor as you think and you begin to build what's next for you. When you begin to think about the experiences that you want to have in your life and you start creating the foundation of what's going to hold you as you do that experience, as you have that journey. You know, this week I've been listening to David Goggins' new book. Do you guys know who David Goggins is? He wrote a book. His first book was called Can't Hurt Me. And then his next book just came out and I think it's called Never Finished. Anyway, David Goggins is a former Navy SEAL. He's a savage. His story is really, really unique and super interesting to me. He runs. And if you follow him on social media, like he just runs all the time. And it's interesting because in the book he says, everybody thinks I just run. But really, like really, I'm pushing the limits of my body. You know, this foundation that he had was p- piss poor. He didn't have a good upbringing, and he transformed the foundation, and then he just tests it. He tests it with physical endurance events. That's how he chooses to do it. We can each choose to do that in a different way, right? Because that's how we have experiences and we grow and change. If you haven't heard his book, that the one that I'm listening to now, and I'm listening on Audible, I'm going to tell you, first of all, listen on Audible, because he does like little mini podcasts in between the chapters, and it's super interesting, and the guy that reads it is really good. The second thing is, start with the first one, because it actually is like a first and second part. You know what I mean? Like, you got to hear the first one to get the second one, but it's so good. Can't Hurt Me is the first one. Get it. So good. So I listened to the first one in like 2 days. I walked my dog a million miles just so I could keep listening. And it always inspires me to start running again. That's why I thought of this, because of the marathon. But then I don't. So, but it does inspire me. So I want you to think this week, like, as you decide, like, maybe you have goals, maybe you have experiences, maybe you have things you want to know and learn about yourself next year. Maybe you have words, right, that are your thing. I want you to ask yourself, what's the foundation that I need to have in place in order to build that? What's the foundation I need to have in place in order for that to be possible? And if I don't have it in place, what do I need to do now to make that happen first? If I can help you, just reach out and let me know. This is going to be an amazing year. I'm excited. I'm so happy to have been here with you this past year. Is this my last episode of the year? No, there's another one. I am taking off from the 20th to the end of the year. So I'm kind of excited about that. I'll be in and out, not doing too much. So I'm going to just try and regroup and get ready for all of the amazing experiences that are ahead for me in 2023. So I love you so much. You are awesome, and you've done a great job. I know this year hasn't always been really easy, and you've kept going. You're still here, and I think that's freaking awesome. All right. Have an amazing week, and I will see you next time. Hey, thanks so much for listening to today's show, and thank you for sharing the show with your friends. I love when you guys do that. I appreciate it so much. And thank you for leaving me a review on iTunes. I know that it matters, because when I go to find a podcast, I always look to see what the reviews are. So it really means a lot to me that you take a minute to like figure out how to even make that happen. Now, if you want to find me on social media. I'm usually on Instagram, starting out on TikTok. It's just my name, Betsy Paik. And that's my website too, betsypaik.com. And you can find out all about the work that I do, having me speak for an event that you might be helping to plan, or getting trained inside my Alchemy Institute. But to make it really easy, if you want me, just shoot me a DM. Shoot me a direct message on Instagram, and I will be at your service. Thanks again for listening, and I will see you all next week.